Hi friends, as part of the brake system in the automobiles, the previous video we talked about the energy transformation from one state to the other state and how the kinetic energy is going to be converted as the thermal energy in the brake system. Now this video I'm going to talk about the functioning of a power assisted or vacuum assisted brake system, that is conventional brake system in the vehicles what we use, the passenger cars, light commercial vehicles and the medium commercial vehicles. Before discussing in detail about the braking system what we have in our vehicles, let us look about the evolution of the braking mechanism. We'll see the prior to 1900, people used wooden logs as the braking agent. There's a wooden log, and these are lever edges, and these are the lever edges of the wooden log. You can see this is the braking mechanism of wooden log, and this system was used mainly in very slow moving vehicles, that the vehicles which run maximum 10 to 15 kilometers per hour, like steam locomotives, horse carts, etc. And as the by 1902, a well-known vehicle manufacturer by name Mr. Renault has developed a brake with drum system, drum brake. It was having, this is a brake drum, it was having, initially it was having a cable connected to the chassis. So there was a winding mechanism over the drum. Then in due course of the time, the cable is replaced with the brake band mechanism. This is a brake band, which is used as a braking agent, and the brake band is made with the asbestos material. And as there were challenges in maintaining this brake system, the further development has led to introduction of the internally expanding brake shoe. This is external brake band which holds the rotating drum externally. So next, the development is to hold the drum internally, means expanding the brake shoe, which is having the friction material and making this shoe to expand. How it works? It works like this. This is a mechanical cam. The mechanical cam is moved. The brake shoe expands and hold the rotating drum. So by 1910, this system was introduced. And first, the development was, the mechanical force was not sufficient, or it was very tidy to stop the vehicles. They have introduced the hydraulic system, hydraulically actuated brakes. They look like this. So instead of a mechanical cam, what we have seen in the earlier slide, there will be a hydraulic cylinder, wheel cylinder. Oil is pumped inside the cylinder, and the cylinder inside piston expands like this, and the piston will further move this shoe outward towards the rotating drum, holding the rotating drum. This is how it looks. This development is by 1923. Now the further development by 1960, as the vehicle technology is increased and the speed of the vehicles also is increased, they have developed a system called caliper disc brakes. This is how the caliper disc brakes looks. Now in our vehicles, majority of the vehicles, front wheels are fitted with the caliper disc brake, whereas the rear wheels are fitted with the drum brakes with internal expanding shoe. The caliper disc brake, how it works, we'll see. There will be inside caliper mechanism with pistons and all like this, and the black spots are the, these are lights like this, it will be there. When the oil is pumped from the master cylinder, the way the wheel cylinder pistons are expanded, same way the caliper pistons also expands and hold the drum, rotating drum. Now let us talk about the brake system which is being used in the majority of vehicles, that is passenger cars and light commercial vehicles what we use today. This is how the brake circuit looks like this. So you can see the so many parts in the brake system. The first one is the brake pedal, which is pressed by the driver. Then this is called the brake booster. This is a vacuum booster. And then next to it is the master cylinder and the fluid reservoir. Then from master cylinder is the master cylinder. The outlet lines goes, one line goes to the front left, then front right, then the line goes to the rear wheels. Okay. In this car, you can see the rear wheels are fitted with the drum brakes with internal expanding shoe. You can see the wheel cylinder here. These are the brake shoe, half round shaped brake shoe. Then in the front wheels, it is fitted with the caliper disc brakes. This is the system in majority of the vehicles we can see in the present generation vehicles. We can also see all the four wheels are with the disc brakes, but majority of the vehicles are fitted with this arrangement. Rear two wheels are with the drum brakes and the front two wheels are the disc brakes. Now, how the system works, let us see. First, let us go to the drum brakes, how it works. This is the fully expanded view of the brake booster. Okay. This is the pedal. See the brake booster. Brake booster is having two chambers here. This is towards the master cylinder side and this is towards the pedal side. And the master cylinder chamber is connected to the engine vacuum. So always the vacuum is being maintained in this chamber. And whenever the pedal is pressed here, the atmospheric air with the atmospheric pressure, that is 1 bar, enters into this chamber. That creates the differential pressure between this chamber, vacuum chamber, and the pressure chamber. So that differential pressure makes to move this diaphragm forward, pushing this piston or spool of the master cylinder. The movement of this master cylinder forward. Then what happens? Let us see. This is how. Again, the line goes to rear side wheel cylinders and front side the caliper disc. Yes. What happens here? We have seen about how the booster pushes this master cylinder spool forward. Imagine there is a oil reservoir here. The master cylinder, this side is filled with the fluid. When this rod moves forward, the piston also moves forward, forcing the fluid forward direction, as the fluid cannot be compressed. So whatever the pressure movement of this fluid or the pressure in the fluid makes to move these pistons, expand this volume inside the wheel cylinder, which causes movement of this wheel cylinder, both the pistons outwards. As the oil comes here, occupies this space, as it cannot be compressed, then this both the pistons will move outwards. When the both the pistons move outwards, because this outward is anchored to the brake shoe, both the brake shoes, this is the brake shoe. So when the pistons move outwards, the shoe also moves outwards. This is the brake shoe. Okay. And this is the gap between the drum and shoe. So when it moves outwards, this shoe, by moving forward, holds the rotating wheel. How it happens? Look at here. So when the pedal is pressed, the booster pushes this rod and the master cylinder spool is moved forward. From here, the oil is pumped. The master cylinder spool acts like a pump. Oil, whatever is here, it is pumped forward towards the wheel cylinder. So when it goes inside the wheel cylinder, this piston expands like this. And the piston outer ends are connected to the brake shoe, half round brake shoe. The brake shoe also moves forward. See this? the gap, whatever is there, it is vanished when they move outward. When they contract, you can see the gap between the shoe and the drum, this orange line. When they move outward, they move outward and hold the rotating drum, causing stopping of the drum. This is how the internally expanding shoe drum brakes functions. Again, explain you, the pedal is pressed here and the differential pressure is created inside the brake booster, then which causes movement of the master cylinder spool to move forward, creating the pressure in the brake line. That pressure causes or leads to movement of the wheel cylinder pistons outwards, and movement of the wheel cylinder outwards causes movement of the brake shoe outwards towards the rotating drum, thus holding the rotating brake drum. This is how the drum brakes function. And let us move to the front side disc. This figure you can see, same pedal pushing, brake booster, master cylinder moving this master cylinder piston forward. So the oil goes to the caliper device, the caliper assembly. The caliper assembly is having piston here and the piston there. Okay. And when the oil is pressurized here, both the pistons will move towards the disc. Means they come closer because of this arrangement. When they come closer, you can see the red surface is the brake pad. That is a friction disc. So when they come closer, the pressure is applied here. This piston is moved towards the disc and this piston is also moved towards the disc. So when the piston is moved towards the disc, the brake pads also moves, holding the rotating disc. As soon as the pressure is released from the system, these pistons, the pressure is released in the complete line, the pistons will automatically go back to its original shape and the brake is released. This is how what we have seen. When the pedal is pressed, the master cylinder is moved here. You can see what happens when the master cylinder is moved like this. See, it is moved. The oil is coming in this tube and it is going to the caliper. Here the caliper is with one piston and two brake pads. In this case, you can see the caliper is having both sides the pistons. You can see the different configurations of the caliper disc brake, right? This is how the conventional power assisted hydraulic brake works. In the majority of the cars, what we use, go through these modes. If you have any queries, you can contact me through the email.